Okay, hello everyone. It is Thursday, and it is another study session accountability day. So I am signing on stream. Let me rewind. So my name is Aaron. I am a data scientist currently in Medicare, and I have started this thing inspired by Tina Huang, who's a data scientist at some FAANG company. Honestly, don't follow her on YouTube, so I don't know every detail about her life, but it got suggested to me, her discussion of she forces herself to study by doing these like kind of public streams and just trying to get other people to keep her accountable. And I thought that was very admirable. So I've started doing the same thing. So at least twice a week, I hop on stream and I start following all along with the lectures and taking notes and stuff. And I'm generally open to chat or anything that happens on the side. But it's really for me to like kind of be accountable to actually study something and force myself to do it, you know? So lately I've been reviewing my stats because one kind of weird thing with being a data scientist is that the field is very broad and you end up maybe doing some things and losing some of your exposure to other things. So at work, and also with my personal projects, I tend to do natural language processing focused projects. And I found that my statistics knowledge has been those skills have been dulling a little bit. So that's why I've decided to go back and study some statistics. And I went back to base principles because I found that in trying to review a bunch of these statistics classes, they pretty much just jump straight into doing, well, just using statistics in some combination of machine learning or code. And I see the value in that. It is totally helpful. Like, I get why you want to start, like, you know, you take the equations and theory from statistics and you apply them in a computer, and then you're using those to solve problems. Totally makes sense. The problem is that a lot of those equations and theories actually have underlying assumptions, and you want to make sure that you actually know what those assumptions are so that they're actually valid when you apply them. So, like, really easy thing to watch out for is like if you have a bunch of variables that turns out they're like collinear, and you just throw a machine learning model without like simplifying your data, like it's maybe not, you could have saved some work by just kind of thinking through what you're trying to work with first. I am going through, it is in the description, but I will put it in the chat. I'm going through this playlist from Curtis Miller, who at the time was teaching statistics over at the University of Utah. I've shared this a few times, but you know, if you've never seen these things before, then like I totally get like maybe you want to be aware of what's going on. And I keep signing into OBS on different devices, so now I have to hide this from you. So this is obviously my non fancy mechanical keyboard. It is pretty funny. I really love that thing. As you can see, this and this, it is a split ergo keyboard. It is a joy to type on. I really like all the clicky clacky. And the general responsiveness of the keyboard. However, funnily enough, I got the wireless one, as you can probably tell, and they're powered by batteries. They're powered by very small watch batteries, and the only ones I could find were either old or very cheap. So, one of these, this one, that I keep using whenever I play Halo, super funny. It just kills the batteries. So I have one working battery, which I think is in this, so in case I want to play again, and then one which is totally dead. So they don't have half a keyboard. I have gone back to using this like more normal wireless ergonomic-ish sort of keyboard from Logitech. Let me see if I can reload YouTube chat. All right. I will paste the. This is the source lecture. If you're signed on and watching, how are you doing today? You know, are you also looking for accountability buddies, either for studying or I don't know, working out or anything like that. I guess a personal note, if you want to share non-study things, I am trying to get in the 1,000 pound club this year. So I'm trying to make basically what that means is your total one rep maximum for all for bench, squat, and deadlift is going to be 1,000 pounds. So I am currently at tomorrow. I had to increase the weight for squat and deadlift, so I'm maybe pushing 300 on both of those, and that's with a 5 sets of 5. So I'm pretty excited. It's like a, it's not really like a goal to. It's not like an end all be all goal. It's just like a, I wonder if I can do it, like be in the 1,000 pound club. Yeah, anyway, so I don't have my notebook today. Everything's logged in. So instead, I'm going to take notes inside, Wordle. I'm going to take notes inside OneNote and then just transfer them over to my notebook later. Yeah, I found that a number of these classes, there's a lot of like working through examples, so I tend to work through those a little faster. And yeah, so without further ado, we are going to be in chapter 4, I believe, and the class today is cumulative probability distributions. Yep, cumulative distribution functions and expected values. So yeah, it's going to be pretty cool. So with that said, I'm going to mute myself and I'll keep an eye out on chat, and then I will just follow along with the class. So yeah, oh, actually, let me. I am rearranging on my windows and stuff. Cool. So you can probably tell I've got OBS on the bottom right, lectures up in the top right, and then I have got OneNote on the left-hand side, and there's a lot of space for it. So this is section 2, and it is cumulative distribution functions and expected values. And you may see me kind of like walk in pace or place, and it's because I don't have my treadmill today, my under desk treadmill, and I am definitely short on steps. So I'm gonna mute myself and I'm gonna start watching class. So I will keep an eye on chat and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye. Hopefully it's not too distracting. I am going to stretch while I'm watching these classes. So I'm laughing a little bit because Curtis and the instructor is basically marking up PDF to talk about the notes, and unfortunately he didn't make enough space in the PDF to actually do handwritten notes. So it's like, oh, we're just gonna have to erase everything that we just did for the past 20 minutes. It's kind of like chalkboardy, where you're like working on the chalkboard and then all of a sudden it's like, oh, I need the space back, so I hope you wrote everything down. Luckily, this is just like a very thorough example dealing with the uniform and exponential distribution functions. So it's pretty, especially with the uniform example, it's like pretty obvious what's going on. So now he's actually going to go into R code, it looks like, to demonstrate like the actual and get the actual values of the calculations. So I think, now might actually be a good time for me to take a little bit of a break, to go get some water and maybe an orange. I'll be right back. I'm gonna pause this. And I guess for FYI, I am watching this on 1.25x speed, so it's been about, I think, third, a little over 30 minutes. I wanted to actually stop at like 45 minutes in, which would have been, I think, a 40-minute stream. But I would have kept going, except I got thirsty. I'm watching at this 1.25x because it's a little bit easier for me to follow along. And then if I need to rewind, I just kind of, I do the arrows and I go back 5 seconds and write stuff down. But luckily, since this is just following along with an example, it's pretty clear. Okay, I will put on the intermission screen. I'll be right back. Okay, we are back. I am resuming stream. My snack, I did not get an orange because I already had two today. I had these. Let's see if it will focus. Yeah, real fancy today. Actual Quest protein bars, not Kirkland brand. Although the Kirkland brand ones are fine. They're great. They're the same. Okay, going back onto mute and then back into the class. Sorry, I don't know if you just saw, but I held my hand up to my monitor because it feels warm. I don't know. This monitor's from like 2008, I think. So the technology is like a lot older. I think it just gets like warmer than most things. So I'm like, oh man, why don't I have the fan on and everything? It's, yeah. Right, and commenting on the actual class. The current example is trying to work through the integral form of the expected value and the variance, and then deriving, or actually like computing what those are for particular kinds of the uniform and exponential random variables. So he's just writing a bunch of calculus right now. So Curtis solved a bunch of the examples, or example 9 for the uniform random variable needs more space, so he went back and cleared everything out and then summarized it, and now is doing it for the exponential random variable. So more walking through some calculus. So that's cool. He finished going through an example with the exponential function and using x squared. And it was really cool that a trick comes up, which is you learn to recognize integrals you've done previously, especially when they equal one, and then it just saves you a ton of work. So yeah, he was pointing out that some of them were like, oh yeah, you've seen this. This is a PDF. Probability density function, or this is the expected value of a different function, which is one. So yeah, now he's going through R code for the same thing, just basically, I guess, proving what he said before. Okay, cool. So that was the end of that lecture. The next one is going to be normal random variables. And he said that for the rest of this section, there's going to be a lot of like doing specific kinds of random variables. Just like the examples used were the uniform and the exponential. So now we're going to like normal and then a few others. So been streaming for, I know I took a break in the middle, been streaming for an hour and a half. I think I actually might call it just because the next class is an hour. And considering I'm still short on steps, and I looked at my thumbnail when I was like walking in place and I was like, that's not good. So I think I'm gonna go out for a walk, try to get some fresh air because I've been inside all day, catch up on my step target for today, and then who knows, maybe I'll actually just bring my phone and then like watch the class while I'm on my walk. Actually, honestly, this sounds like a good idea. So yeah, I will check in I think next week. So Tuesday, like normal for accountability. And we'll see if there's like other announcements and stuff from me. I guess big news, I finally purchased some custom domains, and I will, I guess, be working on some websites. So yeah, it's pretty exciting. It was a big morning this morning before work. Okay. So again, my name is Aaron. I'm a data scientist. I am here for these accountability studies just to make sure I keep studying, keep my skills sharp. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. And if there's anything you're trying to study to try to get better, like, and you want an accountability buddy, just let me know. I would love to talk to you, try to see what you're up to, and see how I can help, I guess. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day and maybe great weekend if I don't see you. All right, checking later. Bye.